Hi everyone, welcome to Alpha Media UG, and in today's video I'll be showing you a new method on how to recover your Facebook account if you lost access to the phone number, email or even password. So I'll be taking you through each and every step on what to do. Now, step number one, you're going to open your Chrome browser, and then on the search bar you're going to type facebook.com, then space, then account recovery. Facebook.com account recovery, and then you click search. So after entering, you're going to go to the second option, recover your Facebook account if you can't log in. So you click on that, then you continue with Chrome. Then now in the description of recover your Facebook account using the find your account page, so you're going to tap on that link, facebook.com/login/identify. Now, since you don't have access to the phone number and even the email, you search by your name instead. So you click on that, search by your number or name instead, but you're going to put your name, and then you click search. So when you do that, it will bring a list of options that bear your name. Then you select your account. Then you don't have your password, so you click try another way because you lost access to your password too. Then since you even lost access to the login details, the email, so you click no longer have access to this. Now you, from here, you're going to follow these steps. Tell us how you can reach you. So you're going to put your new email. Then the next thing will be confirm your identity. Then now you'll be able to have access. So when you're putting in the new email, you make sure that you put the email that you've never used in any Facebook login credentials, right? So you put in a new email that you've never used in any Facebook account. Then you click get code. Now the code will be sent to that email. So you go and open your Gmail app, and then you get the email that is sent by Facebook. You open it, and then you copy that code. So after copying this code, you go back and paste in the other recovery process. So if you don't get the code, you can check this other video on how to fix code not received. So then you paste the code there, then click confirm. So after doing that, the next step is for you to upload your ID. So the ID can be a government ID or a driver's license or even a passport. But when you're uploading an ID, you make sure that you've scanned it very well and all the words are clear. Now in the name, you're going to put the name that is on your ID. Full names, because when you're verifying, they will need to cross-check the name that you've provided with that on the ID. So you put the full name that is on your ID, and then under choose files, you tap on it and it will redirect you to your phone storage. Then you choose your ID. Then after that, you click send. So when you send an ID, usually it takes a few minutes for them to reply back to you. But in some cases, it can take like 12 hours or even 24. But for me, it took just like 5 minutes. And for those who are always scared about the security of their ID, Facebook does not retain the IDs. The ID gets deleted 30 days after it has been verified. Now, immediately after you sending your ID, you can check back the email to see the progress and to track the process of your recovery. So you'll find that you will now be in step 2, which is in review. So reviews, as I said, the time varies, but maximum is 24 hours, but you can even get reviewed in less than that time. So after that, they will send a new link that you're going to click in order for you to be able to follow the next steps. So this will be the final step on resetting your password. So you click reset password, and to redirect you to a new page that you're going to put a new password with a new phone number or even a new email, right? So when you tap on that, you go ahead and type the new password. Make sure this password is strong. It bears characters, letters, and even maybe some symbols, so that you can't easily be hacked again. So after that, click next, and then now you can enter a new email that you'd like to use for logging into your account. If you have existing emails and you still want to continue using them, we just tick the boxes next to those emails. But if you want to put a new email, you just go below that and type in the new email or new phone number, and then you confirm, and then you click submit. So immediately after submitting, you will have access to your Facebook account. So this is the easiest way on how you can easily fix this error. And as I mentioned before, if you're having challenges with "we don't recognize your device" error, when you reach that part of "no longer have access to this," you go and open your Instagram, search for Alpha Media UG. Then after that, you click follow. So you follow me on Instagram. Then after clicking the follow button, you can now click on the message button. Then you send the message. But when you're sending a message, since I always receive many messages, this is what you're going to type, so that I can easily know how I can help you. But friends, one thing you have to note is that when you're inboxing me, please don't request me to unlock or recover the Facebook account for you. I can only give you guidance and steps on what to do, because recovering Facebook account, usually in most cases, it needs you to be in the same location and probably using the same device that you've been using for logging into your account. So personally, I cannot recover your account outside your location. So that's why in most cases, when you're sending a message, only ask for the directions or the steps on what to do. So this is how you structure your message. "Hello, I recently watched your video on how to recover Facebook account. Unfortunately, I got stuck on the 'we don't recognize your device' error. What should I do?" So I'll read the message, and then I will send you the procedure and even the text on what you can type and send to Facebook. So when you type your message, you just click send. Don't worry, I may not reply immediately because of many requests, but I'll be trying to check through every day to see how I can help each of you. And also, I don't recommend you following the bot comments in the comment section. People telling you follow so and so on Instagram to recover your account. Those are bots, please don't follow that. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell, so that each time I make a new video, you'll be among the first to watch.